we're getting chills seeing, you know, what was an empty field quickly packed with so many people coming together, giving high fives, enjoying this time together. And Chris, we have a very special couple guests here with us right now.
We are so happy to welcome Perry Ettinger here. You are one of the original organizers. You made this all happen. And you have a very special connection to Pat Tillman and running.
Yes, I was Pat's athletic trainer when he was at Arizona State, took care of his injuries. And then when he left and went with the Cardinals, I trained him for his marathon, and we continue to be friends.
What do you think when you look out and see all these runners?
You know, it becomes pretty emotional. It's really pretty cool. It's a sad reason we're here, but it's so wonderful who it helps.
Absolutely. And you are actually going to run this race three times today?
Well, yeah, it's only 4 miles. I mean, you got to keep doing it. You got to enjoy it. You got to get out in the crowd. You got to live for what it's for, worth.
You know, and we talked about seeing kids cross the finish line. So you actually ran and trained with this little guy. Tell us.
This is Miles, my son. He's 6. This is his first time through the big run.
And tell us why he's named Miles.
Well, I like to run, so his name's Miles. We have a little daughter, and my wife wouldn't go for the name Kilometer, but we're good with Miles.
You know, we're looking at people run the finish line. A lot of people have really been pushing themselves today, but there are so many smiles knowing why people are running today.
You know, that is. This is, you know, I've been to other races, and they're good, but here people are happy. And it's really cool to see so many happy people and just celebrating a great life.
And I love the story because you were athletic director when Pat came to you and said, I want to run a marathon. And football players don't typically do that.
No, they don't. It's not a smart thing to do. Marathons slow you down, and they decrease your power. And so I told him no, and he said, dude, I'm going to do it. You going to help me or not? And I was like, okay, then let's go.
When he came out here, every time that you're running, you run it multiple times every year. Not just the emotion of seeing the crowds here, but when you're running it yourself, what is that like for you, thinking of Pat?
You know, I know that his spirit's with us. I know he'd be proud of the things that this race accomplishes and the people that it supports. And it just makes for a great day.
When you started organizing this, did you ever think it would get to be this big, 30,000 runners today?
You know, the first year, I said there'd be 5,000. All the race experts said we'd have 800. I said, no way, we'll have 5,000. We had 5,500. A friend of mine came up a couple years later and said, you're going to end up with 28,000. I said, dude, you're crazy, but I'd love for that to happen. And here we are.
We are about to go to a commercial break. Before we go, tell me, what do you want people to know about Pat Tillman and his legacy?
Pat was someone who every day laid it on the line, was honest with himself, and was honest with people. If other people could be that way, we'd have a great place.
Couldn't have said it better. We'll be back with more Good Morning Arizona.
Thank you, Perry.